गुड मॉर्निंग बॉयज, टुडे आई विल डिस्कस मेरिट्स और एडवांटेज ऑफ लिमिटेड लायबिलिटी पार्टनरशिप।
मेरिट्स और एडवांटेजेज ऑफ लिमिटेड liability partnership, in short you may write LLP, limited liability partnership. Number one, easy procurement. Easy procurement of capital. Number two, easy procurement of members. Number three, efficient management. Number four, easy admission of a new partner. Number five, perpetual existence. Number six, quick decision making. See one by one. The first merit, easy procurement of capital. In LLP, there is no limit of the maximum number of partners. So, limited liability partnership can manage additional capital by increasing the number of members. If more and more person will be admitted as a partner, they will supply the capital. Consequently, the total capital of the LLP will increase. In this way, we can say that LLP can manage additional capital by increasing the number of members. Second, easy procurement of members. In LLP, the liability of general partner is unlimited. Liability of general partner is unlimited and liability of limited partner is limited. In LLP, unlimited liability and limited liability, both type of partners are permitted. The liability of general partner, liability of general partner is unlimited, while the liability of limited partner is limited to the extent of capital contributed by them. In this way, we can say that LLP offers both type of liability, unlimited liability as well as limited liability. Now it depends upon the persons to choose according to their requirements, according to their capacity. If they like to become the general partner, then their liability will be unlimited. And if they want to take limited risk, then they may join as a limited partner or a special partner. So this means LLP offers both types of liability, namely unlimited and limited. Therefore, there will be no problem for the membership. Any person can join either as a general partner or as a special partner or limited liability partner. Number three, efficient management. The LLP is managed only by general partners. The liability of general partner is unlimited, while the liability of limited liability partner is limited to the extent of their capital contributed by them. In this way, we can say that the general partner takes more care. General partners do all the work very carefully, sincerely, timely, so that there may not be great loss to the business enterprise. If there to be loss, their personal property can be seized. Due to this, the general partner or general partners do all the activities of the business, manage all the affairs of business very carefully. And as a result, there will be efficient management, because general partner will be responsible for each and every activity of the LLP. Limited liability partners has no right to participate in the management. No right. The LLP is managed only by the general partners. Therefore, general partners are very cautious at the time of taking any decision or at the time of managing the affairs of business. Therefore, we can say that the management of LLP is very efficient. Number four, easy admission of a new partner. A new person can be admitted as a new partner with the consent of only general partner. The consent of limited liability partner is not required. So we can say that the admission in LLP is very easy and simple. Next, perpetual existence. The registration of LLP is compulsory. It has separate legal entity from its members. Therefore, the death, lunacy, insanity of any member has no effect on the life of LLP, because it has separate legal entity. Perpetual success. Therefore, the LLP enjoys perpetual success, long life. Next, quick decision making. Limited liability partners have no right to participate in decision making. All the decisions are taken by general partner. So, the general partner will take all the decision very quickly and are prompted. These are the merits or advantage of LLP or limited liability partner. Now see, next question. Demerits or disadvantage. Demerits or disadvantage. Second question. Demerits or disadvantage of
LLP.
Limited Liability Partners. Point number one, difficult formation. Number two, lack of enthusiasm of limited liability partner. Number three, pressure of work. Number three, pressure of work, lack of secrecy, lack of secrecy. Number five, less credit worthiness, less credit worthiness. Number six, restriction on withdrawal. Restriction on withdrawals. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number one, difficult formation. The formation of LLP is not easy. It is difficult. The registration of LLP is compulsory. So various legal formalities are required to be completed. As you have seen, the registration of general partnership is very simple. Registration of general partnership is not compulsory, while the registration of LLP is compulsory. So various legal formalities are required at the time of formation of LLP. Therefore, it is time consuming as well as cost consuming. So we can say that the formation of LLP is difficult in comparison to general partners. Number two, lack of enthusiasm of limited liability partners. Limited liability partners have no right to participate in management of the business. They have no right to participate in decision making. So it is discouraging for them to invest their money in the LLP. So that is called lack of enthusiasm of limited liability partners. Number three, pressure of work. The general partner is responsible for each and every affairs of the business. Only general partners have right to participate in management of the LLP. So there is a tremendous pressure of work over the unlimited partner or general partner, you can say. There is a pressure of work because general partners are responsible to take decisions in time, manage all the resources properly, and there must be proper integration and coordination among different employees, because their liability is unlimited. So they are more cautious, or they are bound to be cautious to run the business enterprises smoothly. Therefore, we can say that there is a tremendous pressure of work over the general partner or unlimited. Next, lack of secrecy. Limited liability partnership is required to submit its annual report before the registrar every year.
So it is not possible for them to maintain the secrecy. It is not possible for them to maintain secrecy. Means partners are unable. Means general partners are unable to maintain the secrecy. It is so because the LLP will have to submit its financial result and financial position to registrar of the firm. So, secrecy cannot be maintained in LLP. Next, less creditworthiness. Lenders hesitate to grant loan to the LLP. It is so because the liability of limited partner is limited to the extent of their capital supplied by them. So they do not grant the loan. They do not like to grant the loan because they feel risk. Because only the general partner will be responsible. So we can say that so far as credit worthiness of LLP is concerned, that is comparatively less than general partners. Next, restriction on withdrawals. Limited partner cannot withdraw. Limited partners cannot withdraw their capital from the partnership firm. Similarly, they cannot take advance from the LLP. Therefore, we can say it is discouraging for them. The restriction on withdrawal, the restriction for taking advance from the LLP. So these are the defects of the LLP. Now see the next question. Difference between general partnership and limited liability partners. Third question. Difference between general partnership and limited liability partnership. Limited liability partnership LLP. See the difference. I will make three columns. Number one, basis of difference. Number two, general partnership. And the third column is limited liability, limited liability partners. See, the basis of difference, number one, registration. Just I want to write only few words, not compulsory. Limited liability, compulsory. Number two, legal status. No separate legal entity. No separate legal entity. Separate legal entity. Separate
legal entities. Point number 3, liability of partner. Liability of partners unlimited, both unlimited and limited. Number 4, maximum number of members, maximum number of partners or members, you can say maximum 50, no limit, no limit. Number 5, management of business, managed by all. Or any one of them acting for all, managed by general partners only, general partners only. Number 6, stability, less stable, more stable. Number 7, admission of new partner, with the consent of all partners, with the consent of only general partner. And the last, applicability of Indian Partnership Act 1932, applicable not applicable see one by one registration. On the basis of these some words, you can distinguish between general partnership and limited liability partnership. Registration of general partnership is not compulsory. It is optional. Registration of limited liability partnership is compulsory. This is the first difference. Number 2, legal status. General partnership has no separate legal entity from its partner. While LLP has separate legal entity. Means limited liability partnership has separate legal entity from its partner. Number three, liability of partners. The liability of partners in general partnership is unlimited. Liability of all partners is unlimited. But in case of LLP, liability of at least one partner is unlimited and liability of other partners are limited. So both type of liabilities are available, are found in LLP, unlimited as well as limited. Next, maximum number of partners in general partnership is 50 and maximum number of partners in LLP is unlimited or there is no limit. Management of business, general partnership is managed by all partners. Means all partners have right to participate in management of general partners. Or it can be done any one of them on behalf of all, with the consent of all partners. But so far as LLP is concerned, LLP is managed by general partners only. It is managed only by general partners. Means limited liability partners have no right to manage the affairs of LLP. Next, stability. The general partnership is less stable in comparison to LLP. It is so because the death, insolvency, insanity of any partner may dissolve the partnership. But in case of LLP, the partnership will not be dissolved due to the death, insanity or lunacy of any partner. Therefore, it is more stable. Admission of new partner. In general partnership, a new person can be admitted with the consent of all partners. In other words, you can say that a new partner can be admitted with the consent of all partners. Means, with the consent of all partners. But in case of LLP, new partner can be admitted with the consent of only general partners. Next, applicability of Indian Partnership Act 1932. All the provisions of Indian Partnership Act 1932 are applied in general partnership. But provisions of Indian Partnership Act 1932 are not applied in limited liability partner. Why mind it? On the basis of some key words, you can distinguish between general partnership and limited liability partnership very easily. Thank you, Vaj.